So let me just explain you the previous example again. What happened in NTMO? So for example, let me take the same question, CH3CH double bond CH2. Okay, when HBr, only this thing happened in case of HBr, and in presence of a peroxide COO whole 2 O2. This is a peroxide. So this is a bit of a special type of reaction. This type of question you can get in your competitions as well as in your board examination, since this is a exception one. Okay. So what happened at that time when your HBr breaks, your in MO, we used to add hydrogen where on that carbon in which number of hydrogen are more. Anna? But in case yes, of ma'am. Substitution reaction, we used to add it where hydrogen are less in numbers. Okay. So we'll add with this CH3CH2 and CH2Br. So hydrogen will be attached to this and Br will attach to this. That is why this is known as NTMO rule. Clear? Now, let me just give you one more example. For example, if I react HCl, same HCl with this, HCl in the presence of C6H5COO, whole twice O2, this is a peroxide. So what happened? Since peroxide is there and HCl is there, but we will not follow the substitution rule with HCl. We will follow the same, similar MO here. MO will be followed by, because this is a simple substitution reaction. So here CHCl plus CH3. All right. This is a simple electrophilic reaction. No shifting will take place. Remember this thing. Sometimes we used to do shifting. We used to do rearrangement. Why we do arrangement? Rearrangement so that we can find a stable compound. Since we have a long chain, so there is no need of rearrangement here. Okay, let's just move to one more question of cyclic compound. For example, this is a cyclic compound, and let me just make it alkenes. Okay, since we are preparing alkenes to alkyl halide. So let's just take some examples of this cyclic compound also. So, for example, I'm having this alkene and I want you to react it with HCl. So, since it is reacting with HCl, all right, no peroxide. If peroxide, we used to add peroxide or peroxide is there, so it doesn't make any difference on this reaction. So, what happened? To which carbon your electron will move? According to MO, your MO will be followed here. Okay, because since a simple substitution reaction, your MO will be followed. So when your this pi bond breaks, it will move to this carbon. Okay, which means that we used to put positive sign over this carbon. And substitution will be same. Here the hydrogen will add and Cl will add to this. Since one methyl group was there, so no shifting, nothing. No shifting is required. Nothing is required. This is a simple substitution reaction. Okay. Let me take one more example. HBr. Okay. Let me take example of HBr in this. This is the same compound. Methyl group is there. But now I am just changing the HBr. Remember, in this reaction, we don't have any peroxide. Right. So this reaction will be simple substitution reaction. Same, Br, H will come there. Means electron will shift there, a positive charge will come over here. Same reaction will be there. But if I change it, this reaction, and add peroxide along with HBr, peroxide, for example, C6H5C double bond 2O2. At that time, MO will not be followed here. Okay, so which reaction will be here? At that time, the hydrogen will add, means the shifting will be like on another way. The hydrogen will add here and your bromine will add with this carbon. So this is a exception case. Means hydrogen will move to that where less hydrogens are present. All right. Here we are moving to the more number of hydrogens. All right. In this more number of hydrogen, hydrogen will move to the more number of hydrogen carbon atom. Okay. But in this case, hydrogen will move to that where less number of carbon atoms are there. Okay. But this thing happens only in this case where your HBr is present with upper oxide. Got it? And if I add HCl and peroxide together, then what happened? For example, same compound. I'm just telling you all these examples in a within a compound, only a single compound. HCl is there, and we just add C6H5CO whole twice and O2. A peroxide is there. So what happened? Then also this reaction will be simple type. Why? Because this is HCl, not the case of HBr. So you just do the simple substitution reaction, that will be Cl here and hydrogen will come here. Same reaction as MO does. Okay, so your MO theory fails in case of HBr. That is why, and especially in the presence of peroxide, that is why this is anti-MO theory, or you can say anti-MO rule. Clear? I just want to tell you one more type of substitution, allylic substitution. This is that was in your course, but sometimes you used to get some questions in the competitions about this allylic substitution. This is not important for board examination, but sometimes you get questions. Rarely. Previously, it was in your syllabus, but in the revised syllabus, they just deleted. I just want to explain this thing to you so that you can answer if you just means see this type of question in any competition or your exam. So that is allylic substitution. That will be allylic substitution. But this is actually a different type of substitution. Here the substitution of your halogen will takes place on that carbon, on the carbon next to double bond. Double bond will not participate, means the substitution will not take place on the carbons where double bond is present. Let me just tell you this thing with the help of example. CH3, CH, double bond, CH2. Double bond is there. Okay. Now, let me add reagent in this. So, what happened? Hydrogen or halogen, whatever you are reacting, sorry, hydrogen means even whatever halogen you are reacting here, that's just come to the carbon which is next to the double bond. For example, this, your halogen will attack on this. This is what happened in allylic substitution. Instead of breaking this double bond, instead of, you know, producing carbocation or carboanions, your halogen will come and attach to this. And previously this was CH3, now it is CH2. Hydrogen will remove out of it. Clear? And these reagent may be, how many types of reagents may be there? Let me just tell you this thing. First, the reagent may be halogen. This reagent may be halogen, especially at high temperature. This is the special condition, and that will be ranging from 400 to 500 degrees Celsius. Okay. That will be 400 to 500 degrees Celsius. Second reagent is be NBS. Have you heard about NBS in 11th class? I think you all have heard about it. What is NBS? N-bromosuccinamide. सक्सिनामाइड NBS is N bromo succinamide. For BR, this actually if this happens only in case of this will be used for BR only. But if you want to add chlorine, if you want to substitute chlorine in your reactant, at that time SO2Cl2 will be used for chlorine. So if you want to means, for example, if we are taking any halogen, whether it is iodine, bromine, chlorine, fluorine, you can take anyone. But condition is temperature up to 400 to 500 degrees Celsius, high temperature. Second, NBS. If you want to substitute, we used to take reagent. In place of reagent, we used to add NBS here. So bromine will attach to the reactant. And if you want to substitute chlorine, so for chlorine source, we'll take SO2Cl2. Clear? Now, let me just explain you this with the help of an example. CH3, same, I'm taking same example. For example, CH3, CH, CH2. Okay? If I add chlorine at approximately, for example, I'll just taking 460 degrees Celsius. Means chlorine at 460 degrees Celsius. So higher temperature is needed here. So what happened? Your chlorine will substitute the carbon which is next to the double bond carbon. Clear? Double bond participate nahi karega, wo uske next carbon pe idhar se aayenge. So next carbon is this. Agar ye long chain hoti, if this is a long chain, then only this, then also this halogen will attach to the carbon which is next to the double bonded carbon. Clear? Okay. Let me just take one more example. Same reaction with Br on 600 degrees Celsius. For example, this is 600 degrees Celsius, high temperature. So then also this reaction will be same. Br will attach to this CH, double bond, CH2. Okay, let's just take example of another reagent. For example, I just want to take NBS. For example, this reaction with NBS. NBS matlab N-bromo-succinamide. This is the source of bromine here. But when you take NBS, then at that time, instead means you can just take heat also. Even you can take light and HU. Heat or light, when you boil, means heat it, light it. So at that time, what happened? Your bromine comes and attached with the first, means the carbon next to the double bonded carbon atom. So this is all about your allylic substitution. Okay, these are the different types of substitution among all of the others. So in these two, three classes, we have studied about MO. Let me just give you a short summary. MO rule. In MO rule, we used to add hydrogen to carbon with maximum hydrogens. This is a short kind of summary. Second rule is electrophilic substitution or addition rule. In that, proper mechanism will be there. All right. But in case of HBr, this rule is opposite. This is known as NTMO for HBr only, where hydrogen attached to carbon with minimum hydrogens and with other, your halogen will attach. Last one is allylic. In allylic substitution, your halogen will attach to the carbon next to double bonded carbon atom. But are clear? Yes. Is this clear to you all? Okay. So let's just start with the next topic, preparation of haloalkanes from alcohols. Okay. But if you are learning anything means regarding alcohol, you will learn in this chapter. Next chapter, alcohol is quite different from this one. So what do you mean by alcohol? When your alkyl group is attached with the OH group. This can be any alkyl group. Alright. So when your alkyl group is attached with this OH group, what happens? Same substitution reaction will be there, but the process is different. Types of reactions are different. Okay. So let's begin the preparation of haloalkenes from alcohols. Okay. So these halo means your alcohols, how your alcohols forms, means ethyl alcohol, methyl alcohols. We have different types of alcoholic compounds. So this R is ROH, and this alkyl group can any type. It can be methyl, it can be ethyl, any type of function will be there. So what happens when your ROH, your alkyl alcohol, react with a reagent and form RCl? What happened? Your OH will remove out and your chlorine, or you can say any halogen, will attach. Okay. So let me just explain you what we call this type of reaction. These type of reaction are called nucleophilic substitution reaction. Clear? When OH remove and your one nucleophile comes and attach in place of that, these type of reactions are known as nucleophilic reactions. So I just want to tell you about the reagent. That what is that reagent? These reagents are actually specific. How? Let me just tell you one by one. Your first reagent can be concentrated HCl plus anhydrous ZnCl2 beta. This one is the most important reagent which we used to use in the preparation of haloalkenes from alcohol. This is known as Lucas reagent. Clear? This is known as Lucas reagent when we mix concentrated HCl plus ZnCl2. We'll use this for Lucas test also. Okay? Second reagent, it can be your PCl5. It exists in both gaseous or it can be in solid form. So you will get, means the product will be same. Means after reacting with gaseous PCl5 or after taking this solid reagent PCl5, your product will be same. But there will be a difference. What in difference? Mechanism. There will be a difference in mechanism. Okay. There will be a difference in byproducts. Your byproducts will be different. Your mechanism will be different, both in solid and gaseous state. Okay. So, but the product will be same. Next is PCl3. In PCl3, PCl5 and PCl3 both are the means both have chlorine and phosphorus, and they can just give chlorine to the hello, means remove the OH and chlorine will add it. But some means same condition is there. Product will be same with among PCl and PCl5. PCl5 and PCl3 product will be same, but the byproducts are different. So whenever you'll get the questions and whenever you get the reactions from both PCl5 and PCl3, there will be a difference in mainly byproducts. So at that time, you have to recognize that which reagent is used here. So since you are getting objective paper, so they can ask you that this is the reaction, identify the reagent. So on the basis of the byproduct, you will be able to identify that either you take the reagent is PCl5 or PCl3. All right. Next reagent is SOCl2. This is the best method. This is the best method of preparation of haloalkenes from the alcohols. Clear? So these are the reagents which can be used in a reaction for the preparation of haloalkenes from the alcohols. But while doing the reactions or while doing the name reactions, you must know that which reaction which of the following reagent we are taking to perform the reaction. So for the first example, let's just start with the Lucas reagent. First reagent. I'll just tell you each and every means about reactions related to all the reagents. So let us start with Lucas reagent. And Lucas reagent is concentrated HCl plus anhydrous ZnCl2. Okay? So let me just give you one example. ROH plus HCl, and HCl also in concentrated state. In presence of HCl, I have taken here in the product side, and anhydrous ZnCl2 will be used as catalyst here. So there will be a combination of ZnCl and ZnCl2 and HCl. It combinedly form Lucas reagent. So what will be the result of this reaction? RCl plus H2O. This is a nucleophilic substitution reaction. Nucleophilic substitution reaction. What happened? This OH will come out of this reaction and Cl will adjust in place of this. And HCl, that means you will get RCl and H2O will be your byproduct. Now I'll just tell you about the mechanism. How this reaction takes place. This is actually important. Mechanism is important because we know the result that what happened, OH will go out and HCl will take its place. As we know in the substitution reaction, this thing happened in nucleophilic substitution reactions and also in others also. But the most important is mechanism. Okay, so let me just tell you what is the mechanism of this. Remember this thing. Whenever we react, means when we do a reaction in the presence of a catalyst, your catalyst will take part in the reaction. But at the end of the reaction, it comes into its original state. See, ROH, oxygen is there with the two lone pair of electrons. Clear? One is bonded with hydrogen, is bonded with alkyl group, and it has two lone pair electrons. Plus ZnCl2, since we add ZnCl2, this is also known as zinc. We know this thing that zinc behave like a Lewis acid. Okay, so what happened here? The bond between this oxygen and this alkyl group break. How? Cause what happened? Oxygen has tendency to to extract the electrons. भाई ऑक्सीजन की टेंडेंसी ये है कि वो इलेक्ट्रॉन एक्सट्रैक्ट करती है, मजबूर कर देती है सामने वाले को, भाई अपने इलेक्ट्रॉन्स मुझे दो एंड जस्ट कंबाइन विद मी. ऑलराइट, बट व्हाट हैपेंड हियर, दिस एल्काइल ग्रुप डोनेट इट इलेक्ट्रॉन टू दिस, मींस सॉरी, दिस एल्काइल ग्रुप एक्सेप्ट द इलेक्ट्रॉन, मींस इट्स जस्ट स्नैच द इलेक्ट्रॉन फ्रॉम द ऑक्सीजन एंड गिव इट्स पॉजिटिव चार्ज. So what happened? The electronegative character of this oxygen increases. Why? Because this alkyl group removes one electron from the oxygen. Since oxygen is electronegative, but if you extract one more electron, so what happened? This is more electronegative. So if someone asks you that among oxygen and O positive, which one is more electronegative? O positive. Okay? So when this alkyl group take one electron from this oxygen, what happened? This bonds break and they get separated from each other. Now the product will be R plus ZnCl2, and the electron displacement will be there and OH minus sign will be there. Okay, clear? This is the first step, or you can say intermediate step. In which carbocation is formed. This is carbocation. Clear? And which type of carbocation is this? Which type of carbocation is this? SN1. In 11th class, I have already told you about SN1 and SN2. Since beta class will be and automatically within 1 minute, we'll continue with the same reaction tomorrow. Okay? अभी इस मैकेनिज्म को यहीं रोक देते हैं क्योंकि खत्म नहीं हो पाएगा बेटा ये. Okay?